In this video, I will show you how to create professional book cover mockups for free. If you are a self-publisher or author looking to showcase your book with a professional 3D mockup, you are in the right place. I will walk you through how to easily create stunning 3D book mockups using ChatGPT's image tool. And the best part, we will be using only the free version. But before we start, I have been having some difficulties lately reaching more people, so I really appreciate your help. If you are enjoying the content, please like and comment below. It really supports the channel and helps me reach a wider audience. Now let's dive into step 1. The first step in creating your 3D book mockup is to have your book cover ready. You will want to make sure the cover image is high quality and in the correct dimensions for your book. For the best results, save your cover as a PNG or JPG file. I recommend PNG because it preserves image quality and supports transparent backgrounds, making it perfect for 3D mockups. Now that your book cover is ready, it's time to create the 3D mockup. For this, we will use ChatGPT's image creation tool. The Foro image generation feature is integrated into OpenAI's GPT Foro model, which is accessible through ChatGPT. This advanced image generation capability allows users to create detailed and photorealistic images directly within the ChatGPT interface. The key to getting a great 3D mockup is in the prompt you write. Here is a quick breakdown of what to include for a clear and effective prompt. The first one is the book size. Make sure to specify the book's dimensions, like 8.5 by 11 inches for a paperback. Next, we have angle. Define how you want the book displayed. For example, you could say slightly tilted or at a 45 degree angle to create depth. The third point is thickness. This refers to the number of pages. For accuracy, you might include something like the book should have approximately 100 pages for realistic thickness. Then we get to lighting and shadows. You'll want to mention realistic lighting to make the mockup look natural. A good example is with soft realistic lighting and shadows. Finally, background. Indicate what kind of background you want. You can say plain white background or something more specific like on a wooden desk with a laptop. For example, you could use a prompt like this. This will generate a sharp, professional looking 3D mockup in just a few moments. Now that we have created our first 3D book mockup, let's explore more variations to make our book stand out. Having multiple mockups is great for marketing, whether you are posting on social media, creating ads, or designing your book listing. Now to generate different mockups, we are going to use carefully written prompts that help create realistic and engaging scenes. Scenes that really match the theme of your book. Since I am working with a book about self-publishing, I will try to create scenes that reflect that world. Let's start with an example. A book mockup on a wooden desk with a laptop and a notebook. This kind of setup tells a story. It gives the vibe of someone writing, editing, or managing their self-publishing business. It feels real and relatable. To make this happen, I will use a prompt like this one. Feel free to pause the video here if you want to copy or customize it for your own book. As you will notice, I have included key details in the prompt. The size of the book, which is 8.5 by 11 inches. The camera angle, the lighting style, and the background. These little details help get more accurate results. These are just quick examples to get you started. With a bit of practice, you will be able to write even better prompts. And that means even better mockups. Alright, our image looks great so far. We have got the book, the laptop, and the notebook on the desk. Now let's take it further with a real cool feature in ChatGPT, the selection tool. Alright, here's how it works. First, make sure your image is ready, just like this one I have been working on. It's a clean workspace setup with a book, laptop, and notebook. Now let's say you want to add something to the scene, like a coffee mug. You don't need to place it manually. Instead, just grab the selection tool and highlight the area on the desk where you want the mug to appear. Next, in the prompt box down here, I will type something like add a coffee mug to the selected area on the desk. Simple and clear. Then I just hit enter. Oops. Okay, I am currently using the free version of ChatGPT and it looks like I have hit the image creation limits. Right now, because of high demand, the free version lets you generate up to 2 images per prompt. That might change in the future depending on availability. If you need more images right away, you could upgrade to the paid version. Personally, I'm still testing things out before committing, but honestly, based on what I have seen so far, I'm really close to going pro. The results are just that good. But for now, I will use a simple workaround. I will come back tomorrow and try again. The free image limit resets daily, so you can keep experimenting and generating new mockups day by day. Alright, I'm recording the next part the following day. So let's continue. I select the area again, type the same prompt, and let's see what happens. So, ChatGPT added a coffee mug. Not exactly in the spot I picked though. It might be because the spot I selected was a bit too narrow or awkward due to the photo's angle. If you compare the before and after, you will notice the angle shifted slightly and the book looks a bit wider. But honestly, I still love how it turned out and I'm going to keep this image. And remember, if you are not happy with the result, you can always try again. Alright, now let me quickly walk you through some more examples and the prompts I used to generate these images. Feel free to pause the video if you want to read or copy any of them for your own use. I will go through each one quickly so we don't waste time. Here is one, a book held by a person in front of a bookshelf. Another one, on an e-reader or tablet next to a print book. Or on a cozy coffee table with a cup of coffee. Now let's check out some with people in the scene to make the mockups feel more relatable and lifestyle focused. Business person holding the book while speaking or teaching. Person unboxing or holding a stack of books. Business person holding the book at their side while walking. Over the shoulder holding shots. Book on the table with a hand reaching for it. Person pointing at the title on the cover. Holding the book during a selfie or video call. Book in a tote bag being pulled out. All of these were created using similar prompt structures. You can experiment with your own details and get even more creative results. I also want to show you an unsuccessful image that I generated. There's a spelling mistake on the spine of the book. This kind of typo happens sometimes when AI tries to render text on a book covers or spines. To avoid this, it's a good idea to include the exact title you want written in your prompt. For example, show a book with the spine text, Financial Intelligence. It helps guide the AI to get it right, though it's not always perfect. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you'd like to see another one where I show how to create interior page mockups using ChatGPT, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment. Even something as simple as helpful or keep going really helps support the channel. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.